As travel begins to pick up, maybe it's been a while since you last flew and gone through airport security, or maybe it'll even be your first time. In either case, the last thing you want to do is get to the airport security checkpoint and feel lost, confused, overwhelmed, and feeling the wrath of the frustrated line of passengers behind you. So in this video, I'm going to cover a list of mistakes to avoid to help make your airport security experience as smooth as possible. Dream vacations start here. Hey, if we're just meeting for the first time, my name is Ben, and on this channel, I provide weekly travel tips and information that'll help you when planning your next vacation. So let's go ahead and jump into the first mistake to avoid, which is arriving to the airport unprepared. A good way to be turned away at security is not having the proper documentation. For domestic flights, you want to make sure you have either your driver's license, passport, or military ID, and your boarding pass in hand when you get to the TSA agent. Don't be that person who still has their ID in their purse, bag, or wallet when the TSA asks for it. If you're flying international, you'll definitely need your passport and your boarding pass. Just make sure to check the expiration date on your passport. Most countries will not allow you to enter their country with a passport set to expire within 6 months. Also, you'll want to check what the entry requirements are for the country you are visiting. Do you need to get tested or vaccinated in order to enter the country? Is there a form to fill out? And even some countries require to get travel insurance as well. It's also important to consider what is required for you to return back to your own country. At this time, even vaccinated U.S. citizens need a negative COVID test in order to fly back home. The number two mistake to avoid is forgetting to give yourself plenty of time. More and more people are starting to travel again. Airlines are getting busier, which means longer security lines. This is why it's essential for you to arrive early and be prepared for the completion of every step of the travel process from the time you arrive to the airport, check your bags, get through security, and ultimately to your gate. There's nothing worse than trying to elbow your way to the front of the security line because the wait is longer than you expected. If you're new to the airport process, then I would recommend getting to the airport at least 2 hours before your flight or 3 hours if you're traveling internationally to avoid the frantic rush. And moving on to number three is not packing strategically. One of the worst mistakes you can make when going through airport security is packing items that you will need to take out in a place that is not easy to get to. Keep your ID, boarding pass, passport, and your phone in your pocket or in a place that you can easily grab them if you need to. If you're traveling with any liquids, those will need to come out. And remember, you can't have liquids more than 3.4 ounces per bottle, and they all have to fit in a quart-sized bag. So just remember to pack those in a place that you can easily get them out, either at the very top of your carry-on or your personal item bag. When you're putting items in the bin for screening, you only need to put those items that are larger than a cell phone in those bins, like a laptop, tablet. Your shoes and jackets will need to go in there, but for everything else, like your phone, your belts, jewelry, I would recommend putting those items in your carry-on or personal item bags. Not only will they keep them safe, but you'll have less stuff to take in and out of those bins, making for a quicker line. And if you're finding this video helpful so far, let me know by liking the video or subscribing, or you can leave me a comment if you have any questions. I'd be happy to answer those questions for you. Number four is packing prohibited items. Packing items that are prohibited through airport security can really slow down the line since a TSA officer has to then open your bag and remove the prohibited items. If you want to see what the TSA rules are for what you can and cannot bring through airport security, be sure to check out my other video on the top 25 airport security questions answered. I'll post that video in the video description below, so be sure to check out that video before packing your bags. You can also check out the TSA website, and on their homepage, they have a feature called What Can I Bring? Here you can type in the name of an item and it'll let you know if it should be packed in your checked or carry-on bag or if it's forbidden entirely. They also have an app called MyTSA. This app will give you 24/7 access to the most frequently requested airport security information on any mobile device. And moving on to number five is dressing uncomfortably. When going through airport security, you're going to have to take off your coats and shoes, so be sure to wear shoes that are easy to take off. Avoid strappy sandals and laces if you can, and be sure to wear socks unless you're really okay walking barefoot through the gross airport floor because ew. And I would recommend layering your clothing because the person you are sitting next to in the plane might want to blast his or her air vent, leaving you cold if you're not wearing the right clothing. And lastly, number six is not investing in TSA PreCheck. If you fly more than twice a year, TSA PreCheck is worth the investment. Or better yet, if you do a lot of international flying, Global Entry is even better because it also includes TSA PreCheck. And if you have no idea what either of these programs are, they're essentially a fast pass through airport security and through customs. In fact, according to the TSA, in August of 2021, 96% of PreCheck passengers waited 5 minutes or less to be screened. Benefit about using TSA PreCheck is that you won't have to remove your belt or your shoes, and in fact, your laptop and liquids can stay in your bag. And if you happen to be traveling with children 12 and under, they can go through the PreCheck lines with you without having to enroll them. If you're looking for more information about either program, I actually did a video explaining both TSA PreCheck and Global Entry and how you can enroll in them. You can find that video linked in the video description below. And speaking of video description, if you're looking for more resources, I have those available for you, including links to TSA approved products, which might be useful to you when packing, as well as a link to my website if you want to learn more about me and my business. Be sure to like the video if you found this video helpful to you. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in a future video.